Let's pull some cards for Saturday. I'm trying to fit in the screen. Five of Cups. Change in emotions. Change in moon position sign. Saturday, and the devil is what we got for the cards, and the cards we get. Five of Swords and the Eight of Wands. Jupiter in Sagittarius, the Eight of Wands, which is swiftness, and Uranus in Aquarius, Five of Swords. And it's split at the High Priestess. And the Two of Cups, Moon and Cancer. On the bottom is the Nine of Pentacles, Saturn and Virgo, if any of these signs mean anything to you. But the High Priestess is connected to the Moon, Cancer, and Taurus. High Priestess has to do with secrets and things that are like hidden knowledge, hidden information, especially secrets of the divine, I think of. Or the dead, even. What's on the other side? Usually something connected to intuition, psychic ability. So you're feeling very in tune in psychic mode with the Five of Cups. Maybe we'll see what the moon is in tomorrow. Moon in Cancer, there you go. New moon, 28 days old. Sun in Leo. So, there we go. Moon in Cancer. Ten of Pentacles, Venus in Virgo. Queen of Wands is on the bottom. And Ten of Pentacles is like a happy ending, a really great day. Wealth, too. So, a lot of fives. Maybe there's some gambling going on. Swiftness, the Eight of Wands. Again. Anything else for Saturday? The devil. Clarity on the devil. Princess of Cups and the Ace of Discs and the Queen of Wands on the bottom here as well, like it was in this deck. Wand Queen. Something distracted me though, so I don't feel like that is the card. Clarity on the double. Wheel of Fortune. So maybe something having to do with time. Since the devil is connected to Saturn, Saturn has to do with time. The Wheel of Fortune, translation for it is timing, amongst other things, but combination with Saturn. Rulership and timing, fortune, Jupiter. We did get Jupiter and Sagittarius with the Eight of Wands twice. So Jupiter is in retrograde right now. Maybe there is something having to do with that crossover between Jupiter and Sagittarius. Maybe messages aren't getting received correctly. Or in time. And yeah. From the Pixie Lenormand deck. See what it has to tell us. Here's like I put this like stuff in it and it's making it really actually just look greasy instead of peach wavy. In any case, Clover 2, the High Priestess is number 2 in the Major Arcana as well, so and we got Fortune, the Wheel of Fortune, Clover, luck. Seems like might be a lucky day to two rainbows on the bottom. There's another rainbow. Stork and the clover. The stork is obviously about deliveries, all kinds though. So again, with the eight of wands and messages coming across the wires, that's what it usually comes down to. Clover, six of diamonds, which is one of the cards we got this past week. I think it was Wednesday, maybe. Card energy is positive. Keywords, luck, quick, optimistic, easygoing, carefree, success, serendipity. Which are all traits that I feel like would describe Jupiter. So Jupiter's benevolent, lucky planet. So full meaning, this card is one of pure luck and fortune. Well, we did get fortune right here. So it brings good tidings and reason to celebrate. A raise, promotion, recovery from illness, a new investment, panning out, being lucky in love, and all-around good luck is the meaning of this card. Be warned that this is not a lasting trend, but a quick stroke of luck, perhaps one of those million-to-one chances. Similarly, finding a needle in a haystack situation encourages you to pay attention, grab hold, and pluck it while you can. Love, a short-term relationship or quick fling. Career, promotion, favorable opportunity or profitable outcome on the job. Characteristic qualities, a humorous and carefree person, a happy person with an upbeat personality. The person can be a risk taker, always on the lookout for a good deal or bargain. Something will happen quickly, either within 2 days or 2 weeks. Also, it could be stand for the month of February. Image origins. The leaves of the clover were created from the Ace of Wands. Rather apt energy to develop that symbol. The pink flowers of the clover are actually the tip of the wand folded over itself and colored with the background of a lover's card. The rainbow background is taken from the Ten of Cups, being all about happiness and contentment. The foundation is from the Knight of Pentacles as well as the Ten of Cups. So, two tens again. Maybe things happening in twos, since we did get the Eight of Wands twice. Maybe spotting patterns. So if you want something to repeat itself, it does. If you don't, then you can be on the lookout for something that, you don't want to happen, I guess. And even here, there's a stork, two storks. So, and there are two clovers here. So again, maybe it's just, things happening in twos is important. Or the second house, which is Leo. Not Leo, sorry. The second house is Taurus. I don't know why I said Leo. I guess just it's my second house, so. Anyways, I hope this was helpful. Maybe I will pull. I mean, it sounds like a great reading, like Ten of Pentacles, Ten of Cups. Doesn't get, better than that. And a change, maybe, perhaps. A lot of messages also getting across, hopefully. And, yeah. or getting to the right people, that kind of thing, and maybe there's reason to celebrate because they do. Okay. I hope this was helpful and you have a great day. Bye.